Hi everyone, Tracy here with Paper Closet Designs. In today's video, I want to show you a new file that I have, and it is the Nugget Box with a gift card holder. And these are for Valentine's Day. I have three of them. I've already sampled this one. This is the one with the little Cupid, and it says for you. It has a printable sentiment, and it also has a printable tag. This one says Happy Valentine's Day. There's a couple of things that you need to know about this. So there is a piece that you can cut out of acetate to make a window, or you can leave it out. This one I've left it out. The candies are big enough that they won't fall through, but you might want that acetate if you do something smaller. They're designed to fit a nugget, four nuggets, Hershey nuggets, but you can put just about anything in them. The pocket up front that holds the tag is also the perfect size for a gift card. So if you would rather put a gift card in there, you can, or you could actually do both. You could put a gift card and a tag in there. It's wide enough that you could do that. So let's get started. I'll show you what is included in the file. We have three of them, and these are all Valentine's. I do have some others, some birthday ones. But like I said, this is the Cricut or the Cupid, and it says for you. And the little tag says Happy Valentine's Day. And then I have a skunk and I have a hedgehog. So we will go ahead and start with the hedgehog. They are all put together pretty much the same way. Now the hedgehog I cut with score lines, and the skunk I cut with perforation lines. So whichever file you're using, there you go. You will need some twine. If you want to tie it onto your tag or ribbon or whatever that you like, you will also most likely want some pop dots, and then you'll need either a tape runner or some glue. And I use my ATG tape gunner, and then the glue that I use is the Scotch Create Tacky Glue, quick drying tacky glue, and I just put it in a small bottle and it helps with the little pieces. Okay, with the hedgehog, you'll have two printables. You have one that says, Be Mine, and you have the tag that says, Hugs and Kisses for You. And then your hedgehog is actually three pieces. So you have his body, you have the back of his body, and then you have the fur, whatever that is, on the hedgehog. You also have some hearts. There's three hearts. The larger heart is for the Be Mine. You will have three of these rectangles, and these are wrappers for your nuggets if you decide that you want to use nuggets and put wrappers around them. And you can cut these out of printed paper, which is what I did for this one. I just cut it out of some of my striped printed paper, or you can do it out of the solid cardstock. And then you'll have your tag. You'll have your optional window. I don't know if you can see that you cut from acetate, and then the box. So let's start with the box. There are all these score lines, and you are going to take everything and fold it up towards you, which is a little bit different. Usually I have you fold things away from you, but on this one, you're going to fold everything up. These go together really quick. There's our window. I'm going to flip it over and do that one away from me just because it's kind of hard to, not hard, but. And then all of the tabs you're also going to fold up. And this piece has a tab that folds up and folds up. Okay, now we're going to take, I'm going to lay this flat down so that you can see. We're going to take this tab right here that's next to the window, and I'm going to put tape on it. Or you could do glue. Then I'm going to flip it over, and I'm going to put tape on all of the tabs with the exception of the two on the window. So just remember that, the two on the window. This one's got tape on the backside, and this one we're gonna open and close, so we don't wanna put tape on it. But everything else, we want tape or glue on those tabs. So this long one, these three shorter ones, whoops. Skip that one by the window. This long one up here, and this long one right here. Okay, and let's flip it over. Now, if you are going to add your acetate, I'm gonna do it on this one. I'm not gonna do it on the one with the skunk, just to show you that it works. All I'm gonna do is take my tape runner and put tape inside that score line. Oops, I forgot to fold one score line. There we go. And put tape inside all those score lines. And the acetate doesn't work very well with glue. It does work with the tape runner. However, you're gonna want a 1/4-inch tape runner or smaller, or score tape will work as well. Okay, so once I've got that in there, then go ahead and just lay my acetate right in there. And smooth it down, and there is your window. Okay. If you don't have acetate, you can also use, you could do vellum, or sometimes I will actually cut out the plastic on my mats, you know, that you've thrown the mats away because they're not good anymore. Sometimes I'll use that plastic as well. Okay, now we're going to do where the gift card or the tag goes. I'm going to turn these two tabs towards me, and then I'm just going to fold this down along that crease line. Just smooth everything out, and there's your pocket for your tag or your gift card. And then we're going to take this and we're going to fold it right up there along the bottom of that. I don't know if you can see this or well or not, I'm getting a glare. And we're going to turn the tab and fold it down, and then it's going to get glued or adhered right underneath where the pocket is. I'm just gonna smooth it out. And then you might wanna bend it a couple times, make sure everything's folding right. On the left-hand side is where we're going to glue it. So we're gonna take these two small tabs first and put them down. And then the tab on the back, we're gonna put it down. And then finally, the tab on the front. And if you've added the adhesive like I showed you to, that'll all come together just perfectly. Okay, so now while this is together, let's go ahead and glue our little hedgehog together. So let me get my glue. We're gonna take this, the darker brown. Oh, and he's got an eye. I need to poke out the eye. So there's our little eye. And we're just gonna put glue on the back of him and then line him up on the bottom. Now this darker piece that goes in the middle has both legs showing. There's a little cutout for his nose. You just wanna kind of match everything up. And then we have the lighter tan. I actually cut this out of the cream, and it has only one leg showing, or two legs, one of each, a front and a back. And it goes on the top. So we have the full body on the back. We have the middle piece that has all four legs showing. And then we have the front piece that has only the two legs showing. And just line it up. And there is our little hedgehog. He's pretty simple to put together. He's just three layers. So you can see that. And now I'm going to glue him to the front of my card. I could add him with pop dots if I wanted to. And we probably will with a couple of the others. This one, I'm just gonna glue it right on. Okay, next up, I'm gonna take my larger heart and the heart that says, "Be Mine." And I do have some videos showing you how to either delete the sentiment, change it completely, or turn it into a print and cut. They're on my video or on my YouTube channel, and there's one for the silhouette and there's one for the Cricut. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and glue this one that says Be Mine right there. And then we'll take these two smaller hearts and just kind of put them on there randomly. There's no right or wrong. Okay. Isn't that just really, really cute? Okay, let's do our tag. For our tag, I'm gonna just tape this. This says Hugs and Kisses for You. Just gonna have it right there. And then you can take your twine or your ribbon or whatever you have, tie a knot, tie a bow, whatever you like to do. I think these would be really cute if you took the tassel maker and added a tassel to the tags. I think that would be a lot of fun. I'm just gonna tie them in a double knot. Get my scissors and trim that up just a little bit. And it can slide right in there. And again, if you wanted to, you could put a little gift card in there. And then I can take a nugget. I forgot to grab my tape. I'll have to get my tape here. And you can just wrap the candy around it. Or the wrapper around the candy, sorry, and tape it on the back and then slide it in. But this one, I put the acetate window in it because I'm gonna take some of my sigslets. I can never say these. I've got some Halloween sigslets, and we're just gonna go ahead and fill that box up with those. Whoa! No, Izzy, no, no, no. My dogs want to chase that candy. Okay. Then we can close it up. And there you have a little Valentine box with some fun. No, Izzy, there's our hedgehog. Let's go ahead and do the skunk next. I'm gonna actually put my tag in there. We'll move the sixlets out of the way. The skunk has a few more pieces. That's why I saved it for last. It's not hard, but it does have some smaller pieces. So with this one again, I just cut some black twine. There's our little heart. It says you are. Let's see if you can see that. You are. Set that aside. The skunk, I will show you all the pieces as we start to put it together. And then two more hearts. You've got your wrappers. And I just cut these out of the red cardstock. And then the tag and the printable says, so stinking cute. So he's gonna hold a heart that says you are, and you pull out the tag and it says, so stinking cute. And then we have the box. So let's go ahead and start with our box again. We're just gonna one more time, take all of those tabs and fold them up towards you. Now this one I did with the perforation marks and it works just fine. Some people like them. Some people would prefer square lines. So it has whichever ones you want. You're just turning everything up towards you. Same with the tags up towards you. I do have some more of these. I've got some birthday ones that I'm working on. And I think I'll probably do some St. Patrick's Day ones. Okay, so now that we've got it, we're going to put tape on this side of this fat tab only. I'm gonna turn it over and put tape on everything else with the exception of the two tabs by the window. I am not putting the acetate in here because I want to show you that you don't necessarily need it with the nuggets. If you want to with the nuggets, it's fine. It gives it kind of a finished look, the window, but I know some people don't like working with acetate, so you don't need to. Okay, we're gonna fold those tabs in and fold this down. My pink paper is just a little bit lighter than the red, which is odd because it's the same brand and they both say they're 65 weight, but I can feel the difference in this. Okay, we're gonna fold this up right here on this crease line, fold our tab down, and then bring it right up underneath the gift pocket. Okay, lift it up, fold the two short tabs down, the longer tab, and then that last tab, and smooth it out. Okay, it's ready to go. Let's take our skunk next, and let's assemble our skunk. So the first thing we need to do is he's actually going to be holding this heart. So I'm going to put glue on the back of my heart and finish it first. Okay, then with our skunk, there are some small pieces, but the machine will cut them out and it goes together really quickly. So we have this black piece, which is his face. We have a face piece. This little tiny pink piece is his nose. Then we have two paws or hands and 4 feet or 2 feet, so four paws. We have another black piece and then we have this white piece. And you'll want to cut these out of black and white the way that I did so that when you layer it, it will look like a skunk. So we're gonna start with our white piece, our solid white piece, and we're gonna glue this black piece to him. So I'm gonna flip him over and add some glue. Okay, there we go. And glue him, just put some glue on him. I like the thinner bottles because I can really get these small pieces. And then we're just gonna layer him right there. Okay, then we're going to take the face, and it has the eyes cut out. And we're just gonna layer it next. And then we'll take this black piece for the face. Match up the ears. Isn't he just the cutest little skunk? And then we're gonna add his nose, and I'm actually going to put the glue right on his nose. And then just add that right there. And line it up. Can't see around the stand. Let me bring this closer to my face. There we go. Okay, now I'm going to add my heart. You are. And then finally, we will add the paws so that he's holding the heart. All right. So there's our skunk. I'm gonna hold him up close so you can see him. And this time I am going to add him with some foam pop dots. Just to give this card a little bit of dimension. Now these boxes would be fun cut out of printed paper. And then solid paper for your nugget wrappers, or vice versa. Don't look at the back of my black or white piece. I was using some scrap paper to cut these out of, and they have printing on one side of them. but you'll never know. Okay, so now we're gonna just add him right there. And you could have him half hanging off if you wanted to. And then we've got these two other hearts that we can add. Take our tag, and we're gonna just, let me cap my glue so it doesn't dry out. We're gonna flip it over and add some tape to it. Oh, so stinking cute. And let's add our twine. And I cut that piece big enough, I betcha I could put a bow on this one. If you like bows. Trim up those edges a little bit, ends. So stinking cute, and slide it right in there. You are so stinking cute. You can write to, from, or any message that you want. All right, let's add our nuggets. I'm gonna grab four of these nuggets. You can use any flavor that you want. And then you'll want some tape. Now, I am doing this out of cardstock. I think that they wrap a little bit better if you're doing something with just a little bit lighter paper, but it will work with the cardstock. So what I do is I just take the strip and I kind of run it between my thumb and my finger to give it a little bit of a curve to it, just kind of train it. So let's do that with all four of these. Then take a piece of tape, take one of your nuggets and start at the top, center it at the top, wrap it around, and then tape it closed. And you don't really want to use glue on these because you want them to be so you can eat them. Oh, and I cut my tape too long, so I'm just going to trim it up. Right there, and then we'll do that with all four of those nuggets. You can also put other candies in here besides just the nuggets or the sixlets like I did with the hedgehog. You could do just about anything that would fit in there. I did do some with the Reese's hearts, you know, the little tiny Reese's hearts, and I was able to get two of them in there, but it was kind of loose. Okay. I have also made these and used sticker paper, printed a pattern inside the sticker or inside the rectangle, and then cut them out of sticker paper. And I think that is my most favorite way to do it because then they just wrap around and stay so nice. You can decorate these up if you want to. Oh, that one came undone. I knew that one was gonna give me some issues. It's just the thickness of the cardstock is all that's, like I said, that this one, the red is thicker than the pink, which you wouldn't think, but it is. I can tell just by playing with it that it is. Okay, so once you have those in there, then you're just going to open up your little tab on this side and slide them in. And then also on the back, you have a little thumb hole, which makes it easy for closing and opening that box right there. And there is our little skunk. You are so stinking cute. So we have the skunk, we have the cupid, And we have the hedgehog. Which one is your favorite? Thank you for joining me today. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please give me a thumbs up. Hit subscribe down below so that you don't miss any of my videos. And have a great day.